So hello and welcome friends to our channel Intromech, and we are discussing about the metal forming processes. And in the previous session we have discussed about the wire drawing process. Now in this session we will discuss about another forming process which is called as extrusion. So we have seen like in wire drawing, this is the wire drawing process. There is a die which is stationary and we are like pulling this rod through this die cavity, and we are pulling it from the front side. Okay, now we have seen the limitation of wire drawing, or now when we apply this pulling force, we have seen that this stress cannot be greater than the yield strength of the material. So this limits the wire drawing process, and the reduction, the maximum reduction possible in this process is limited by this condition, as this sigma say 1 is maximum possible value will be sigma y. We cannot go further than that, as we have seen the reason this rod may get deformed, it will not have a uniform cross section. So that is the limitation of wire drawing process. So what we can do now in the extrusion process, what we are doing, like instead of pulling the material from front side, we are applying a force from the back side with the help of a ramp. So this is called as a ramp. Now this is my die which is a stationary. My ramp is moving in this direction, and the die has a cavity through which this material is like pushed outward. So I am applying a force which is a compressive force. Now in this case the force was a tensile force because I was pulling the wire. Now in this case I am applying the force from the backward direction, like I am pushing the material, and that's why here I am applying the compressive force, which gets converted into the compressive stress of the material. Now the compressive strength of the material is greater than the tensile strength of the material, which gives another advantage in this process, because here we are pulling, there is a tensile stress. So in extrusion we are getting this advantage also. So the maximum possible reduction is not restricted as in case of a wire drawing process. So this is a advantage of extrusion process. The water compressive force which we are applying is directly getting applied into the deformation zone, and at the deformation zone the stress can be greater than the flow stress of the material, and that's why the material gets compressed and gets out from this cavity. Now here we can see, we have seen this is a drawing process. Okay, now in the extrusion process I have shown here two processes, and now if you see carefully, now here the ramp is pushing the material from the back side. Now this material will exert a pressure on this die, and there is a friction between the die wall and the material, and we have to push the material against this friction force, and we have to make the material to flow so that it will take a shape of the cavity of this die. Okay, now this shape of the cavity, here we can put a square section or round section or say hex. So whatever will be the shape of this cavity, the cross section of this tube will be same as this shape. Now here we are applying the ramp force from the backward direction and from this direction, and the material is getting pulled in also the same direction. So this is called as forward forward extrusion, like or it is also called as direct extrusion. Why? Because the ramp is in direct contact with the material, and there is a friction. So because of that, and both the materials are moving in forward direction, that That is why it is called as a forward extrusion. Now, in this case, if we see, there is a die cavity in the RAM. Now, this is the RAM. Now, I am pressing the material in this direction. But if you see, this red color is my material which is flowing in the opposite direction. Okay, so this is my RAM. Okay, and here we can see that the material is moving in the opposite direction of the RAM. So that's why it is called as a backward extrusion, or also called as a indirect extrusion. So these are the two basic types of the extrusion. Now, as we have seen these two types, there are some advantages of forward extrusion and some disadvantages also. So let's compare these two extrusion processes. Now we will see the differences between these two processes. So let's discuss about the differences between these two processes. So as we have seen, like in forward or direct extrusion, the direction of the RAM and the material which is moving both are same. And in case of backward or indirect extrusion, we have seen that the RAM is like moving in forward direction and the material is like moving in the backward direction. So the directions are opposite. Now, how much force, or what is the force required to compress the material in case of forward extrusion and in backward extrusion? Now, as we have seen the process, we have seen that the material has to overcome the wall friction also. So here the force required is little bit higher than the backward direction, but again this force is like it is only initially higher because it has to overcome the friction, but later on it is lesser. So if we see the overall forces that are required in these two processes, the force required in the backward extrusion is not much lower, it is marginally lower than this case. Now, handling. Now if we see, the material is like coming from the front side only, so that's why its handling is easier. Now in this case, the material is coming out from the die cavity of the RAM itself and is coming from the opposite direction, so that's why the material handling is a little bit difficult in this case. Now if we see the tooling cost, now here if we have a RAM, then die design, then RAM design. Now if we consider the forward extrusion, the RAM is like simple, it is only compressing the material and the die has a cavity. But in this case, we have to focus on the RAM design also, because the material is coming out from the RAM. So that's why it has a little bit higher tooling cost than the forward extrusion. Now, if we consider the movement, in this case, the die or the container is fixed and the RAM is moving. But in the backward extrusion, we have either cases possible. That means we can either fix the container and can move the RAM, or we can fix the RAM and move the container. Then which kind of materials we can use for this extrusion process? So if we consider the semi-brittle and brittle materials, now if we consider these materials, in case of forward direction there is wall friction, and because of that there is a cracking tendency which is higher. But in case of backward direction, the wall friction is not available, and that's why the cracking tendency is little bit lesser. But can we use some different kind of extrusion process for these brittle or semi-brittle kind of materials? Yes. Then we have a different kind of extrusion process which is called as a hydrostatic extrusion process. Okay. Now, if we consider the hydrostatic extrusion process, now that its name indicates, it's like a hydro. So the container here is filled with some kind of lubricating material or oil, and because of that the material, this is the material that is not directly coming in contact with this wall, inner wall of the die, and that's why, as we have seen in the first case, the ram is applying the force on the oil, and because of the Pascal's law, we know the fluid exerts equal force in all the directions, so it exerts the pressure on this the liquid exerts equal pressure in the all directions, and hence it compresses this material out of this die. So this is called as a hydrostatic extrusion. So this is the advantages of hydrostatic extrusion, that like brittle materials, we can easily have an extrusion in this case because the cracking tendency is very less. Now again, there is one more process which is called as an impact extrusion. Now in this case, what happens is there is a ram, and we have here, we can see this is a die, and the material is like placed here. Now I am pressing this having an impact of this ram on this material. Now because of that, the material gets the shape of this die cavity, and like here we can see this material has taken the shape like this. So what is the advantage of this extrusion process is like we can produce like thin walled tubes, like our toothpaste tube. So the toothpaste tubes are produced with the help of this impact extrusion process. So we have seen now the basics of the extrusion process, what are the types, then we will see the little bit analysis now, that how much force is required, then what is the power required in this case. So as this sigma O is nothing but the extrusion stress, and it's given by the sigma Y into this formula. Now the B is mu into cot alpha, which is alpha is nothing but the semi die angle which we have seen, and mu is the coefficient of friction. So this is the value of B, and again AO is the original area, and A1 is the final area which is coming out of the our die. Then we have the effective force. Now effective force, as there are two different processes like forward extrusion and backward extrusion, in case of forward extrusion it is like sigma O plus Pf into original area, that is stress into area. But why we are adding this Pf? Now this Pf is nothing but the pressure required to overcome the wall friction, as we have seen that the wall friction plays an important role in case of forward extrusion, and that's why this effective force required is a little bit greater than this backward extrusion. Here we can see the effective force in case of backward extrusion is like sigma O into AO. So this is greater than this. Now how we can find out the power? Is power is nothing but the effective force into the velocity of ram with which we are extruding the material. So this will give us the power. Now how we can find out the maximum possible reduction? So for the maximum possible reduction, from this formula we can see that if the value of B is like 0, the sigma O will become equal to sigma Y, and in that case the effective force is nothing but KO times AO ln times AO by A1, that K is the extrusion constant. Now if I want to find out the minimum effective force, so how we can find out the minimum effective force? Now for that reason we have to consider like sigma like B is equal to 0. Now in that case sigma O will becomes equal to sigma Y, and if we consider this formula, our minimum effective force will be sigma O times AO. So that will be our minimum effective force. Now we all know the efficiency, like the efficiency is nothing but the effective force requirement minimum upon effective force which is actual, like considering all the friction and this B value, whatever the actual amount of effective force which is required, so this value will be greater, and how much minimum effective force which will be a ideal case. So in that case we will require this minimum amount of effective force, and the ratio of these two forces which will give us the efficiency of the extrusion process, right? So the efficiency of the extrusion process, like if we consider the forward extrusion, it is around 0.35 to 0.4, that means like 40% to 30%, and if we consider the efficiency in backward hydrostatic extrusion, it is higher, which is around 0.5 to 0.6, like 50% to 60%. So we can clearly see that we can get a higher efficiency in case of hydrostatic extrusion, because there is a oil which reduces the frictional forces, and that's why the effective force requirement is lesser. So this is the reason why we require the, why there is the higher efficiency in this case. So this is about the analysis of extrusion process, and I hope you understood the process. And if you have any doubts, please do write into the comment sections and we can discuss over there. Until then, be safe and stay happy. Thank you.